Hello everyone, I am Miss Mary from the Pacific Grove Public Library, and this is Crafternoon. So welcome, thank you for joining me. I'm at the library, and I can imagine that you are at home, so thank you, I appreciate your company. We're gonna get started. Today's craft is one hopefully you'll have the supplies at home for. The first thing you'll need is a paper towel roll. And you're gonna also need some paper to cover up the end, right, for a rainmaker. And I've done this with a piece of, it's a grocery bag. You can use construction paper, kind of something thick and strong, because inside we're gonna be putting rice, and you certainly don't want rice all over the house. All right, so to start off with what I've done here to cover that opening is you're going to wanna take your construction paper or paper bag and trace the paper towel and to create like a circle, like that. And then when we finish up, we've got to fill it first. We're going to use this to cover it up. So the other thing you'll need is rice and tinfoil, and then some kind of paper to decorate your rainmaker. So let's see about that tinfoil. You can hear it. So the tinfoil, the purpose of the tinfoil is to slow down the rice so that it doesn't just jump from one end to the other. And to measure it, you'll need to have three times as long as the paper towel. So you're just gonna go ahead and measure that out. And you're gonna tug it out, breaking it or tearing it. Let's see, one, two, and a little bit more. And as you can see, I've completely taken it out of the box. Okay. I have my length of tinfoil. It's three times as long as my paper towel roll. And now this is the fun part. You are going to scrunch it up the long end and kind of put it like a tinfoil snake. Like that. Okay, so kind of scrunch it up. There we go. And then you're going to want to create some curves. I definitely need like a coily snake. Okay, there we go. I've got it. I'm going to put it inside my paper towel roll. And I'm going to push it in there. Give it a big kind of push until it's all inside. Okay, so now my tinfoil is inside. I need rice. So I've got my rice over here. It's in a nice big bag, and you're going to want to use approximately about a quarter of a cup, not too much, maybe less than that, maybe more like an eighth or kind of a small handful. Please make sure that you're being mindful because this can make a mess. Carefully put the rice, like I said, let's go with an eighth of a cup inside the tube. Kind of hear it in there. All right, not too bad. There it is. I can hear my rice. All right. And once your rice is inside, you can see it sticking up at the top. I'm gonna shake it down a little bit. Okay, that piece of construction paper or paper bag from before, I am now going to want to cover the top, and I need to cut it, so I think I'm going to put this down to do that. I'm going to cut up into the center. I don't want to go past the center because we don't want the rice to come out of the tube. And I'm just going to create some cuts right up to where I traced it. Once again, not going past. Okay, so you can see I have all these cuts around the trace circle. And I'm going to put that on top. And, just like this side, I'm going to use the Scotch tape, only because that's the tape that I have. Masking tape will probably work even better. And then I'm just going to tape down the sides. And when you cover it up with your piece of paper, you won't even see this, so it doesn't have to look perfect. It will be covered up by your paper. The idea is to keep it flat. You want this top part flat. Okay, it's looking pretty good. I got a couple more to tape down. All right, looks pretty good. And I've got, maybe a couple more. It's real important that this is taped down well. Once again, you do not want the rice escaping and creating a big mess. Okay, and you can see I'm kind of taping down the sides. Don't worry, it will all be covered up with your paper. Okay, that looks really good. Make sure it's nice and secure. Make sure that this is completely closed, that there's no opening. Okay. All right, now the fun part. Well, it's all fun. I'm gonna decorate it. Like I said, I could use a piece of paper and just wrap it around. I could take this piece of paper and I could use my markers, pencils, crayons, color pencils, whatever. It looks great to me. I can use stickers. And I'm gonna try something a little bit different. I'm gonna go with my paper strips and I'm gonna carefully wrap them around and create a pattern. So I'm gonna stop it here and then I will let you catch up and I'll catch up as well. Thank you. So that's part one.